The Junkers U-288 Schnell Bomber, meaning speed bomber in English, was a German prototype bomber project, designed during World War II, with 22 vehicles built in total. The aircraft was supposed to be a direct successor of U-88, and was intended to be larger, faster, offer cabin pressurization for high altitudes, have longer range, and much greater bomb load, with improved defensive firepower. The design was intended to replace all the bombers in Luftwaffe service, a superior design to be used for most assignments. The aircraft was outfitted with remote-controlled turrets, which allowed them to be positioned much more effectively at strategic locations, without compromising the sleek design, and without the necessity to carry more crew to operate them. The fuselage was expanded along its length, allowing for up to 4 tons of ordnance to be positioned inside the bomb bay, and without the necessity to attach the bombs on external pylons, which would significantly reduce the aircraft's performance. The speed bomber suffered from 2 main issues, with one being its main downfall. The original design was counting with a new type of modern power plant being developed alongside it, the UMO 222 multibank supercharged engine, which was never successfully delivered. The aircraft, while being mostly finished, waited more than 3 years for its engine, before a decision was taken to replace it with a more realistic solution. The final C version, which we have in the game, was selected for a serial production in 1944, but the mass production of the aircraft was abandoned shortly after, with Germany having to face much more serious challenges than development of such aircraft. Despite its issues, the remaining prototypes were hurriedly assembled and deployed in a limited combat duty as reconnaissance bombers. Let's talk War Thunder. This speed machine on steroids is one of the best Silver Lion makers in the whole game. It has several major advantages that almost guarantee the ability to deliver your 4 tons of bombs on target in absolute majority of battles. Combined with its relatively low repair cost and premium status, this machine guarantees profit in every single battle. The Schnell Bomber is, as the name suggests, its main advantage, very Schnell, fast. By default, it respawns at a height of around 3 kilometers, and it is able more than comfortably to maintain a speed of 600 kilometers per hour at this altitude. Most planes will attempt one head-on pass, and then give up. The rest will attempt to turn around, but by then, you will be far away, and they will never be able to catch up. The main weapons of this aircraft are 2 1,800-kilogram bombs in internal cargo bay, meaning 2 destroyed bases without the need to return home. If you overpass your target, you can still attempt to dive bomb due to the availability of dive brake. Apart from that, you have 4 additional defensive turret placements. Quite an insanity on such a bomber, especially with only one gunner, meaning the hardpoints will rarely get knocked out. The 20mm cannon on its tail is just a cherry on top. I don't know why, but even after a year of the aircraft being in the game, people still try to engage you from behind, usually that being the last decision they make in the battle. The aircraft has one additional advantage, which you would hardly expect on a bomber of its size, payload and defensive armament. The agility. This thing is very maneuverable, especially after getting rid of its payload, being able to make very tight turns, without bleeding excessive amounts of speed. It has only 2 minor drawbacks. If one engine is damaged or knocked out, you won't get far. The second is 4 crew members, all being stationed at rather big, oval and glass cockpit. Don't go head-on, because enemies with nose-mounted weapons are your demise. The cockpit is rather easy target. Look at the complexity of its landing gear, isn't it beautiful? It was the second main design issue of this aircraft, by the way. I had a great time making this video, this is an amazing aircraft. Thanks for sticking with me. Stay simple, stay in touch.